Welcome to GV Kids! Enjoy the show! What's up, guys?
What's up?
Welcome to Game Time!
Oh, yeah! It's game time!
That's right. All right, so today, guys, we're playing classic.
Okay.
Rock, paper, scissors.
Ooh.
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot! Yeah, all right, so here's what we go. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. You can either shoot either paper, rock, or scissors.
Okay.
All right, me versus you, and you guys are gonna pick who's gonna win right now. Ready?
All go!
All right, hopefully they picked.
Okay, yeah.
All right, so here we go. You ready for this?
Yep.
Ready? Rock, paper, scissors, shoot!
Oh! Yeah!
All right, Pastor Jason won.
Here we go.
David three. Well, okay, so I have zero. Okay, we're playing. Let's play to five.
Whoever. Now you want to play to five.
Whoever wins to five first. Here we go. Ready? Rock, paper, scissors, shoot! Ah, one. Here we go. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot!
Ooh, tie.
Oh, tie. All right, tie. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot!
Oh!
Two to one. Here we go.
Ooh.
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot!
Oh! I win!
Wait, we're playing five!
Oh, we're playing five.
Yeah. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot! Rock, paper, scissors, shoot! Oh!
4-1.
Come on.
One more.
Okay, here we go.
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot! Rock, paper, scissors, shoot! Oh! I win! I win for real this time! I win!
5-1.
Hey, Pastor David.
Yeah.
I win!
Did you choose Pastor Jason to win? If you did, you're the winner and go get a piece of candy from your parents. I mean, that was crazy.
That was so much fun!
Dude.
That was awesome.
All right, let's move on. Here we go. Okay, so last week we learned about Isaac and Jacob and Esau. Jacob and Esau, they are two brothers, and what brothers don't fight, right? But Jacob and Esau, they had a big fight because Jacob stole Esau's birthright. In fact, he went in when his dad was blind and said, "Hey, Dad, you know, like I'm Esau." He disguised himself as Esau and said, "I'm Esau, bless me." And so Isaac, not being able to see that it's Esau or Jacob, he first of all, he asks him to touch his arms, and his arms are hairy, so he knows it's Esau. And then he talks like Esau, he smells like everything. Ah, redo, he didn't talk like Esau. He talked like Isaac. Redo?
Here we go. Yeah, I'm ready.
So last week we heard a story with Isaac, Jacob, and Esau. And you know, Jacob and Esau, they were two brothers. And well, what brothers don't fight, right? You know, brothers, they just end up fighting. But Jacob and Esau, they had a big fight. Because last week what we learned was Jacob stole Esau's birthright. In fact, he tricked his dad into giving him the blessing. He disguised himself with arms that were hairy. He disguised himself with his brother's clothes that he like smelled like the outdoors or whatever. Kind of stinky, you know? But Jacob tricked his dad, stole his brother's birthright, and his brother was so mad at him that Jacob ended up running away. And so that's where we are now. Jacob is far, far away. Now, in this time, Jacob, he finds a wife and starts a family. And in fact, he has two wives. That's crazy, right? He starts a family and he wants to come back to his homeland. But here's the thing. Esau is there. So Jacob is on his way back. And he's coming up to where his brother lives. And he wants to put his best foot forward. He wants to give Esau all the things that he owns. So he sets up some camels and he puts the camels first and then he sets up some donkeys and some rams and some other cattle and like cows. And then he puts his family and all these different places, he puts shepherds and servants there. And as his brother approaches to meet Jacob, Esau first sees the first sets of servants with the camels, right? And they say, "Well, what's this?" And the servants say, "Well, everything is yours, my lord." And then he comes up and he sees the next group of cattle, and same thing. The servant says, "This is yours, my lord," to Esau. And it goes all the way down to this family, and the family says, "We are here to serve you, my lord." Because Jacob wanted to reconcile with his brother, but he didn't know if his brother would accept it. So Esau's coming, and Jacob sees him off in the distance with 400 men coming this way with his wives and his family and all the cattle. And Esau comes up and hugs him. See, Esau had forgiven Jacob. Esau, he loved Jacob. Wow. Not what I would have expected, right, with this story. I mean, he literally stole all of his things. Like, Jacob stole all of Esau's birthright, everything. But Esau, he missed his brother, and he loved his brother. Now, for you guys, I want you, what you guys to pull out of that story is this, that there is a right way and a wrong way to make amends. Let's go ahead and worship right now. We'll talk about that in just a little bit.
Kick her off, Wichita.
There is calming, there is storm, there is feasting, there is war, there is loving, we are torn.
So Jacob and Esau, they meet up, and Esau forgives Jacob. See, in Matthew 18, 15, it says this, okay? And this is what we need to live by, guys, in our own lives, making amends. If any believer sins against you, go privately and point out the offense. Point out what they did. And if the other person listens and confesses it, then you have won that person back. Like, just go talk to them, right, is what it says. Because if we don't talk to them, then we just build up just the resentment. Kind of like Jacob and Esau, right? Let's pretend this was their relationship. And so their relationship as kids, it was kind of like a little rocky. And then as they got older, it was a little bit more rocky. And then it got a little bit more rocky. And it got a little bit more rocky. And it got a little bit more rocky. And Jacob didn't want to come see his brother. And then he didn't want to come and his put all of his servants, all of his cattle, because he thought his brother was going to kill him. And you guys know what's gonna happen. See, when our relationships are rocky, it doesn't go well. Now, when relationships aren't going well and they're rocky and no one says anything, no one goes and makes amends, it tends to explode. See, but here's the thing. If we take our relationships and we go talk to the other person, like if it's not going too well and it becomes a little rocky and then we talk to them, and then it's not going well again and we come talk to them and make amends, and it's not going well again and we come talk to them and make amends. See, this relationship will not explode. In fact, in the Bible, it says this, guys. It says in Matthew 5, 23 and 24, it says this. If you're presenting a sacrifice at the altar, if you're worshiping God, and you suddenly remember that someone has something against you, leave the sacrifice at the altar. Go and be reconciled. Go and make amends. Go and say, I'm sorry. And then come back and make your sacrifice. Worship God. What I mean by that, guys, is this. If you see that you need to make amends with somebody, you need to go say, I'm sorry for something, don't go do anything else until you say, I'm sorry. And you make amends with that person. Because you don't want your relationship to explode. You want your relationship to be nice and calm. Because our relationship, guys, are the most important thing, right behind our relationship with God in this world. Let's pray. God, we thank you for the relationships that we have in our lives. And we ask, Lord, that you continue just to show us where we need to make amends, where we have to say, I'm sorry, and where we have to forgive others. We need you, God, in our lives to help us with that. Help us to not hold on to the resentment until it explodes in our hearts. But help us to go talk to people and make amends. We love you, God. In your name we pray. Amen. Guys, let's worship God right now.
God of creation, there at the start, before the beginning of time. With no point of reference, you spoke to the dark and fleshed out the wonder of light. And as you speak, a 100 billion galaxies are born in the vapor of your breath. The planets form. If the stars were made to worship so loud, I can see. Thank you.
How about them questions?
Smart sound. Smart sound. Smart sound.